Welcome everyone to this webinar hosted by Toradex. The title of this webinar is How to Add OTA Updates and Other IoT Features to Your Yocto Image. My name is Stefano Viola and I am the Torizon Group Engineer Manager here in Toradex and also play the role of Software Architect. I am based in Italy and before to dive into the webinar, let me cover a few organizational points. Please let's use the chat window of the webinar tool. If you have any technical issues, let us know. And at the end, we will also do an interactive question and answer session. So the webinar will be recorded and made available for on-demand viewing. And so with that, I think we can get started. Yeah, today, basically, I will do an introduction to Toradex and Torizon. We will see what is Torizon OS. And then we have also a demo, let's say an hands-on session. And as I said, at the end of the webinar, we will also do a Q&A session. I believe most of you already know what we do here in Toradex. I think we can summarize with our slogan, that is make embedded computing easy. And with this sentence, we mean at any level, starting from the hardware level with our modular approach that simplifies exponentially the complexity of the design of a new product. But we use the same approach also at software level by releasing an open source and ready-to-use software that allows our customer to keep the focus on their specific application without having to waste time and energy, for example, on the operating system part. So Torizon is our easy-to-use industrial Linux platform. Just as with our hardware, Torizon is built to meet the principles of reliability and security and easy to use, and is able to offer to our customer an efficient, ready-to-use solution that simplify and speed up your product development. As maybe many people here in the audience already know, Torizon is built on top of the Uptane framework. By summarizing and simplify, we can say that Uptane is a comprehensive standard that focuses on secure and reliable software updates, particularly in safety-critical industries like automotive. It aims to prevent tampering and ensure the authenticity and integrity of software update, which is vital for the safety and functionality of modern connected systems like industrial and IoT product in general. But let's try to go into a little more detail what components our Torizon solution is composed of. We can divide the Torizon solution into main components, the device part and the cloud part. For the cloud part, which we identify with Torizon Cloud, it consists of all the services needed to remotely manage a fleet of devices. So it is possible to manage updates, monitor data, and do, when necessary, for example, remote debugging. This part, as I said before, is built respecting the Uptane framework, so is able to offer one of the highest security standards available on the market today because of its design. The device part is composed by all the tooling that we provide to simplify the development, like the Visual Studio Code extension, but also the operating system. Today, we will focus on the operating system that we identify as Torizon OS. Torizon OS is an embedded Linux distribution built on top of our Yocto BSP, and it's fully open source. Since Torizon OS is a customized Yocto distribution, let's see in detail what we add on top of a regular Yocto image. The most important component that we add is our Uptane client that is called Actualizer. It is an open source project that allows us to securely connect our devices to our cloud services. This component is in charge to handle secure OTA updates. In detail, is able to implement operating system updates in the most efficient way. For example, we don't use a double partition system scheme. And with the help of LibOS 3, that is another key component of our system, we are able to perform efficient and secure update by reducing the time to update and especially the size of the update, since LibOS 3 offers a very nice Delta update feature. But it isn't only about operating system update. Our system is able to handle separately application update. We can handle bootloader updates and whatever generic component you have in the system. Like you will be able to update, for example, external microcontroller, FPGA, or just simple configuration file. Then another important component that we add on top of our standard Yocto image is our device monitoring service. With this service, we are able to monitoring the status of the single device by reporting the data that we consider important for our system, for our product. But in conjunction with our cloud services, we do also more because we are also able to aggregate those data for a specific fleet. So in this way, you can have a wide view of what is happening on your devices. Some real example of data monitoring can be, for example, the status of your flash, the health status of your flash, or you can use it, for example, to monitoring your application or whatever you think it's important for your system. You can report warning errors or whatever you think could be important for your product. Last but not least, we add also service to all of us, remote debugging, and this system is just a remote shell service. Is built on top of the Aptane framework and offer one of the most secure solutions for remote access and allow the user to access, of course, the shell for remote debugging session, but also is able to redirect whatever TCP service. So in this way, we can redirect eventually even a full graphical application and be able to see remotely what your customer sees. Let's summarize what I just said. So basically, Torizon OS is our embedded Linux distribution, is ready to use, is open source, is secure, and is also fully tested. Since our operating system is fully open source, we also provide a community version available for other hardware. As you can see in the picture, there is a Raspberry Pi. Basically, Torizon OS is also able to run on Raspberry Pi, and it's ready to be used with our Torizon Cloud services. As we said, implements all the OTA updates and all the other IoT features required for the modern device management. But we provide multiple flavors of this operating system. So there is the Torizon OS standalone builds. That is the one that was always available since the beginning. It's what we envision. It's the best solution to build your product. It's available as binary and is ready to use. It uses a container engine with Docker. And basically, to develop your application, you should use the container engine. It's not required any Yocto knowledge. And also, for the customization of the operating system, you don't need to write Yocto recipe or be able to deal with it. We provide for you all the tools needed to modify our system. But today, what we want to present is this new flavor that it's called the Torizon OS reference image that was made for all the people that know how to work with Yocto. We know that Yocto is basically the most used operating system on the embedded field, so many customers have a lot of skills, and maybe they have also a ready project, ready recipe, software services available for Yocto. So in this ways, with the Torizon OS reference image, you will be able to use your skill to build and customize our Torizon operating system. So the main difference between the standalone image and the reference image is that we removed the Docker container engine and all the service around it. So basically, we just keep all the OTA feature, the device monitoring, all the other IoT feature, except for the Docker container engine. So in this way, when you need to integrate your application, you need to deal with Yocto and use, let's say, the Yocto workflow to create your final operating system. We provide also binary image for this, are just a reference image that you can just download and test it. But of course, here, since the concept is to use Yocto to integrate your application, you will need to build from scratch, add your application, and generate the final operating system image. But in the demo, we will see how is the workflow, how the workflow looks like with the Yocto. Basically, we will see how to build a reference image and also how to generate an update from Yocto for our Torizon Cloud. So, yeah, this is a table that summarizes a bit the difference between our flavors. As I said, our Torizon OS is built on top of our reference image, that it's really the minimum software needed to use, let's say, our hardware. Then we generate what is called the reference minimal image. That is the one that I explained to you. We say that it's not production ready because, as I said, you should integrate your application. So you can't use a binary version of it, but you need to build from scratch by adding your Yocto recipe and your application. It's needed Yocto knowledge, and you can't use our Visual Studio Code extension because all our development workflow is based on containers that will be not available on the reference image minimal. I think we are ready for the demo. Let's get started. Okay, so let's proceed with order. So as you can see here, I have a kind of shell setup. You can see three terminal. That is one, the top one is just a terminal where I have some notes that I will use during my setup here. Here, I have the terminal for my build, and here on the right side, this is my devices where I will do some tests. I prepared a Verdi 9 MX8 M Plus, and I already flashed it with one of our reference minimal image. As you can see, there is the variant minimal. There is nothing on it. There is just, you know, the standard Torizon OS reference image with our standard IoT tools. So it's present our actualizer client that allows the device to be connected to our cloud system. There is FluentBit, and there is the remote access client. Just to show you, I already provisioned the device online. As you can see, this is our platform. And to provision a new device, you just need to click on provision new device, copy the command, and pass the command into the terminal of the device, and you will be able to see your device online. I already did, just, you know, for time, purpose. So, of course, you have many ways to provision a device. There is also what we call provisioning at scale, where you will be able to provision even multiple devices at the same time. So you don't need to just manually copy a past link around. But I will suggest you to search on our developer website about this feature. It's called provisioning at scale. So going back to our setup here, so the first things that we need to do to work with our Torizon OS reference image minimal, it's set up our host system, because as I said, we will be not able to develop our application separately like the standalone image that we provide, where you can use the container. Here, the application will be part of the operating system. So what you need to do is use your Yocto skill to include your application in your operating system build. The first step is set up the host machine to be able to build our Torizon OS system. So as you know, usually what you need to do is install all the packages required to perform the build, the Yocto build. And this really depends on your system. Because for example, for Debian, you need to install some Deb packages. For Red Hat, for example, you need to install other packages. So yeah, this is for sure one way. You can find all the dependencies that you need to build on our developer website, or you can use a more smart and modern way to set up your system. And what I suggest here is to use our ready Debian container on your host system and use it to build our Torizon OS images. In this container that is called Crops, we include all the host dependencies required to build successfully our Torizon OS Linux distribution. Crops is a very well-known container. It's a project made by the Yocto community. What we did is just add a couple of extra dependencies required for Torizon, nothing special. It's already available on Docker Hub. So, and basically this is the command that you need to run to be able to have the system ready. So basically, instead of, let's say, installing manually all the package in your system, you just need to run this command and magically you will have a ready system to build our Yocto Torizon OS image. So let's try it. Let's pass to the command here. Let me highlight a couple of things. I decided to call it crops minimal. It's a name that you can provide. You can use whatever name you want. I binded a host directory. Let me be more clear here. Basically, what I did was create a directory, as you can see, that I called Torizon OS minimal. This is a directory on the host system. And then I binded with a directory in the container that it's called working dir. So basically, the result will be that the content available in this directory on the host system will be also available on the container side. So let's run this command. And as you can see, in less than 1 second, this is real time, you are in the container, be able to use the system and perform your build. So the second step that we need to do is to download the code. And as you can see here from my note, we use the repo tools that is able to use a manifest to download all the required meta layer for the build. We have different manifests. For example, here there is the integration one that usually is used to perform nightly builds. Basically, you will find all the latest feature available on our repository. There is also another one called, instead of integration, default one, that is the one that it's like the production ready one where we use for our quarterly release. In this example, I just used the integration one. And then after that you do this, you just need to do repo sync and the system will download for you all the meta layer defined in the manifest. Here I already did it just for time reason. And as you can see, the result of this will be this layer directory here that contain all the meta layer required to our Torizon OS system. In particular, I want to highlight the meta Toradex Torizon, that is basically where is all the Torizon tools, let's say. After this, what you need to do is configure your build. So first of all, you need to provision your device. And as I showed you, I already did it. My device is here up and running. It's also connected to internet. And as you can see, it's also if I go in the device list here, it's online. I called it product 01. And as I already said, this is a Verdin MX8 M+. So when you have your device ready and visible on Torizon Cloud, what you need to do is set up your OS build. So As maybe most of you already know, to set up and build in Yocto, you need to define the machine. So since I used the Verdynamic M Plus, I'm going to define that one as a machine. Then you need to define the distro, that in our case is Torizon. And then you need to do a couple of common things are common for Yocto developer. Just call a setup script and define the output directory that I call it build-verdin-mx8m+. So let's try to run this command here. And as you can see, the system already show some target that can be used to perform the build and also do a recap of the configuration. This is not the first time that I run this command. The first time, depending on the machine, maybe it can show like the license of NXP, for example. You just need to accept it, and then at the end it will show the exactly same stuff here. And basically right now we are ready to perform the build. So, but since I used here on my device a reference image that basically don't contain anything, it's just, you know, a reference image with basic tools. So what we want to do here is also show the workflow. So basically I want to be able to set up a build, add a package, and at the end of the build, if the build success, of course, the system should also automatically perform a push of my new package on our Torizon Cloud. And let's see how we can do it. So basically the first stuff that we need to do is go in our Torizon web UI and download the credential file. So here, let's download the file. And then what we need to do is set up that file in our build. So let me copy the file in my build system, just a moment. As you can see here, I just copied my credential.zip here in my build system. So now what I need to do is just configure that device in my Yocto configuration. And let's see how to do it. So we need to do in our build directory, conf, local conf, it's the standard Yocto configuration file. And here at the end, we can add this variable. Let me modify it to use the right one. Yes, like this. So you just need to use this variable, sort underscore packet underscore credential, put the path of your credential.zip, and that's it. This is what is required for the system to be able to push at the end of the build your update to your Torizon Cloud account. So now we are ready to perform the build. Let me again go inside the container. Docker container ls should be this one. Docker attach. Okay, now, as I said, we installed on our device just a basic build, you know, just a reference image. There is nothing really available on the system special. I don't have any application that can be used to, you know, build, let's say, my product. Now, as example, let's try to add, for example, a command line tools. Just, you know, to envision a possible workflow. How we can do it? You know, as I said, here are required Yocto skills. So what we need to do is, for example, add our meta layer in our system. We can add the meta layer in our layers directory, for example, and then we can modify, for example, the BB layer conf, that is the one used by the system, you know, to search and check all the layer. You know, the Yocto developer here in the audience should know very well this file. But, you know, just for webinar purpose, let's say, let's simplify this. Let's imagine that we already have a layer available with our application, and we want to just add, you know, our package to the build. Let's, for example, imagine that we want to add to our build the Minicom package. You know, Minicom is a utility used to deal with the serial device. Currently, in this installation, as you can see on my device, Minicom is not available. See, if I type the Minicom command, for example, the dash version. The system tell me minicom command not found. So let's try to add to our build minicom and let's try to push this as update to our system. So what we need to do is open, for example, meta. I will add, you have many ways to add the packages in Yocto. So I will do what is for me the easiest one. I can open, for example, meta Toradex Torizon. I can use one of our RiceApes images. I can use Torizon, for example, common, core common inch. Maybe I really already added here. Yes, as you can see here, those are some packages that we add to our build. And as you can see, at the end of the build, I already added minicom. Now let's try to build it and see what happened at the end of the build. So as I said, now let's try to, let's say, build. And I was going just again to show you the different targets. Okay, now, so we are ready to start our build. So basically, just to recap a bit, we provisioned one device, we configured, we downloaded the credential.zip, and we configured it in our Yocto build. In this way, the system will be able to push at the end of the build the update to our Torizon Cloud account. Last but not least, we configured the machine Verdynamic 8M Plus to be the target machine. And now we are ready to start our build. As I said, we are going to perform the build for the Torizon minimal. So bit bake Torizon, sorry, dash minimal. And in the meantime that the build, you know, perform, let me just highlight that, as I said before, we have other target. The Torizon core Dogger is the one that contains also, as you know, you can already imagine, the Docker container inside the engine, and it's the one that we define as a standalone image, let's say. Last but not least, let's try to envision what is going to happen now. So basically, the system is going to perform the full build. I already did it just again for webinar reason. In this way, the build will take just a few minutes instead of hour. And at the end of the build, the system should also add minicom as package. Then, when the build will finish, we will see appearing in our account. I can show you where. Here, if we go in packages and we select my upload, here, when the system finish to build everything, we should see a new package that basically it's the updates that contains our extra package to be delivered on our device. So about this, let me highlight that this package that we are going to add, we say the minicom, no? This package will be delivered as operating system update. But what means this for Torizon OS? Torizon doesn't use an AB partition scheme, so basically the operating system upgrades doesn't mean that will be replaced at the full partition, but basically the system will generate for you a delta update that contains almost only the modification that you are adding to the system. So in this case, the system will generate a very small delta update that will contains only the minicom packages. So of course, compared to the standalone workflow, in the standalone workflow, the update is completely separated, because in that case, to add whatever application we envision to use the container engine. So means that when we want to add the same package, let's think, for example, minicom, what should we do is use a container that has inside the minicom utility. In this case, the minicom is delivered as operating system upgrade. This is the main difference. Now, going back to the build, as you can see, now the system is performing the OS3 push. So basically, we are pretty close to generate the update to the platform. If you see this yellow warning here, please ignore it. This is just the system that is telling us that there are some directory available in our operating system that are not under the OS3 control. So this is nothing, I mean, to be worried about. It's made on purpose. He's talking about the /var directory. That is the directory that usually we use for data. So please don't, worry about this warning here. So yeah, we are pretty close to the end, 99%. Okay, I think the system finished to build. Yes, now let's go to our package list. And as you can see here, we have a new package uploaded, and basically is a package that should contain the Minicom utility. Now let's try to perform an update on our provisioned device, and let's see if this wall workflow worked. Okay, here in the right side on the screen, we have our device. Let's just open the log of our update client and let's in the meantime, perform the update. So let's go to the platform. Let's select our device. Let's initiate an update. Let's choose Verdin MX8M+ here, since it's an operating system update. And then here, let's select the package that we just pushed automatically at the end of the build. And yes, let's continue. Now that the update is placed, let's go back here. And as you can see, a new update is found. And the system is already performing the installation. And it should be, it's already completed. As you can see, the update was really, 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 really small. Few kilobytes. As you can see, the board is rebooting because, at the end of the operating system upgrade process, the board will just reboot. Let's just wait a bit to see. Okay, here we are. Torizon. So, as you know, we added the utility Minicom. So let's see if Minicom now is present. Minicom --- version. And as you can see, now Minicom is available. And that's it, guys, for the demo. As you can see, the workflow, it's pretty straightforward, should be very easy for a Yocto developer. And this is what we want to basically achieve with this Torizon OS reference image. We want to leave to the expert user to be able to use their skill on Yocto, but still use all our OTA secure feature that Torizon OS provide. Going back to our slide, just to complete our webinar. So what I need to get started today. So as you saw, you can, use whatever Toradex hardware. It's fully integrated and supported. And additionally, as I said in before, it's also extensively tested, let's say. You can request a sample hardware if you want, or you can try out with, if you have a Raspberry Pi or whatever x86 board that we basically support, or you can even build for QEMU, and run your image with QEMU. As I showed you, there are pre-built images available that you can use to experiments, and you can always request the 30-day trial on our Torizon Cloud to be feature complete, use whatever you need for your product and test. And then, be able to use OTA updates, remote access, device monitoring, and whatever you need out of the box. So here, there is just one last slide where I put some reference. You can find some useful link to, get some extra information about this Torizon OS reference minimal image. And I also added the link for our MetaLayer, Yocto MetaLayer, where basically we build Torizon. And with this slide, I think we can start our pool and then go through the question and answer session.
Okay, here we are. Let's read the question. So what's your main reason for adding IoT feature to your device? Complying with the regulation, improving process and quality of life, reducing delivery time, having a safe environment to iterate faster, or order. Let's wait a few seconds before to close the poll. Let's see. Oh, I already see some guy answering here. Okay. Yeah, I think we can also close the poll. So let's start our Q&A session. A lot of questions. I'm pretty happy about this. So let's start from this one. It is possible to include a secure boot with the Torizon platform feature in Yocto as well. The short answer is yes. Basically, we recently did a webinar, a specific webinar on the feature. What is required, since now in this webinar I showed how to configure Yocto, basically you just need to add one line in the local config that enable what we call a Torizon-signed, and the system will generate for you all the required things for the secure boot. If you don't configure the key, the system will generate a key and will use that key to sign every artifact of your system, from the bootloader, the kernel, and root file system. So I invite you to search on our developer website about secure boot. You will find nice reference, and also should be available on YouTube, even the webinar where my colleague Drew explained very well what is, how we implemented it, and how to use it, let's say. Let's go ahead with the next question. So how can we provision a device with minimal Torizon image? I thought provisioning required Docker. That's true. Until we released this new flavor, the provisioning process was with Docker. But I invite you guys to go on the platform, because in the last week we updated this process. And now when you click provision new device, instead of having Docker, the system will use a command that does not require Docker. Basically, we'll download a script that will do all the required things for provision a new device. Let's go ahead. Let's pick another interesting question. So, yeah, this one. I already have my Yocto images building based on Toradex BSP referencing image. Do I need to start from scratch to add the Torizon feature, or I can just add the meta Toradex Torizon meta layer and include it? Okay, very interesting question. So, as I showed in the demo, I downloaded with the repo tool a specific manifest that simplify your work. You know what I mean? Already download for you all the required meta layer that you need to build the Torizon. So basically, when you build the BSP, it's exactly the same. The only difference is that you use another manifest that is the one that allow you to download all the meta layer for the reference image. But at the end, those meta layer, the 99% are the same. The difference is that on the Torizon side, we have an extra meta layer that is the meta Toradex Torizon. So basically, if I should provide you a short question, yeah, you can just add the meta Toradex Torizon to the Yocto BSP and you should be able to build a Torizon image. But I suggest you to just use the, the manifest that already has all the configured layer to download, and for you doesn't change anything at the end. The process is exactly the same, and you will be able, that's the important things, you will be able to reuse all the code. You don't need any adaptation, because Torizon is at the end based on the same meta layer of our reference image. I mean, it's built on top of it. Let's pick this other one. It's also interesting. Can I still use the Torizon Visual Studio Code extension? Okay, the short answer here should be no. Because, why not? Because the with Visual Studio Code extension was designed to work with containers. So since this flavor that we, described today, it's made more for Yocto user, this go a bit out of the concept of Visual Studio Code extension, because as I said, it was made to work with container. It allow you to create a new application from template. It allow you to do remote debugging, even you know, placing breakpoint, do whatever you need. On this new flavor, you can do it because we don't know, you know, it's very open here, the development. You can use whatever tool or ID you prefer. And as I said, this is really oriented for people that, for example, are they already working on Yocto, they already have their meta layer, their software, or they already have skills on Yocto, and they want to just leverage about it. Or maybe because they have a special requirement and maybe they want to really fine-tune, let's say, the distribution. Let me see. It is possible to easily integrate Torizon OS devices into AWS or Azure IoT Hub. Quite complex to say something specific about it because, I mean, in general, yes, I should say, because Azure IoT Hub is nothing more than just a software that can be, you know, compiled and added at build time Yocto. So definitely yes, but I think that with our Torizon platform, Torizon Cloud, let's say, we should be able to cover most of the use cases that already provide, you know, Azure IoT Hub or AWS. But in any case, if you have special requirements, there is nothing that, you know, really doesn't allow you to add those software into whatever, you know, Torizon device, let's say. Can I use this flow to change from OS 3 to an IB partition? If I do binary diff on the IB path, why would OS 3 be better? Yeah, that's a nice question, because I know that, you know, I am pretty old in this industry. It's more than 15 years that I work in this embedded industries, and I know very well that it's the most common architecture on an embedded system. It's still IB partition. In my opinion, it's something quite old today. There are many other technologies that, in my opinion, are more reliable and more efficient. With an IB partition, yeah, you can be reliable, but you really waste a lot of space. And usually, the update system built around those IB partitioning system, they replace the partition. Yeah, in the recent time, there is someone that tried to implement something differential, but still you waste half of your partition. OS3 is way better because it's able to use a single partition and implement atomic update, reliable with the possibility even to do the rollback. How to work this technology is pretty complex to explain now, like just in a question. I suggest you to look in our website. We have many references, even example, and we have also video on YouTube that explain how it works. This, it's pretty nice, and I think it's the best way today to approach this problem with modern, let's say, embedded development. Let me see another question. When, how have you added link to Torizon Cloud? Which causes the image, including Minigom, was automatically seen on the Torizon OTA as update? It was made by Andy accreditation.zip from the Torizon OTA at the beginning of Yocto building. Yes, yes. So basically, this credential.zip contains inside all the required stuff to know, you know, who is your cloud platform. In our case, it's our, you know, Torizon Cloud, and all the necessary things, you know, to be able to push the application. We did it, you know, I know that looks something magical because you add just a file and magically works, but this was exactly, you know, our final goal. Really simplify as much as we can this process. Yeah. I think that's it. We have one other question. Is there any out-of-the-box support for Qt application or accelerated OpenGL contexts? Or would I need to handle the Yocto part myself for that? That's also a very interesting question. So today, with the flavor that I showed you, that it's called the Torizon OS reference image minimal, It's minimal, as the word says, so only implements minimal things in your system. So basically, we added only the IoT tools, you know, the obtain client, the fluent bit for the data monitoring, and the remote access client. If you want to deal with accelerated, graphics, you need to add by yourself today. But we have in our plan also to generate other flavors. One could be an accelerated one. We can provide, for example, a reference image, a Torizon OS reference image multimedia that can already provide for you everything needed to build an image with accelerated Qt. But we heavily suggest, if you don't have a special required, to use the standalone one, where these accelerated graphical things is implemented in our containers, and there is no performance issue, nothing like this. You know, it's really super optimized, that the performance are exactly the same of having it compiled on the on the low level on Yocto. So there is nothing that is different from performance point of view. Last question, and then let me see. Yeah, last question, then I think we can even conclude here our webinar. Why should I use Torizon for OTA updates instead of something like software update or RAUK? Yeah, software update, RAUK, I know very well. Those tools are open source tools that implement, OTA system for devices. There are many things. I mean, let me try to highlight what for me are the most important one, why Torizon is better. So first of all, are both open source. Torizon is open source, is based on a huge community, because we use, for example, S3, that is a Red Hat project used by really million of user, and many. Also our OTA client is a client used in automotive. It's like not our original product, let's say. It's an open source product that we contribute, let's say. So on the, let's say, on the lock-in side, we are on same level as software update and RAUK. The problem of RAUK is software update that are incomplete. So you can install it, but then you need to basically implement your cloud side. There are some available platform, let's say, but provide just very basic unsecure feature, because that's another important feature that we provide on Torizon. It's secure by design. With Torizon, we are also able to implement what is called zero trust. Zero trust means that in a case that also the server will be hacked, no one will be able to, update your device remotely because of how is the design, the architecture. This is absolutely not implemented in software update. It's not that you can't do. You can do, you should implement it. So it's a lot of work, and then you should do maintain. This is something that comes for free in Torizon. So I think there are these and many other small advantages that now, I don't think it's maybe the right moment to answer, but those for me are the best reason. Okay, let me check. I think we completed. So thank you so much to be here, and I wish you a nice end of the day, and see you next time, next webinar. Bye bye.